Tanks are fascinating machines and unbelievable feats of engineering. They have literally turned the tides of wars like World War II. But this Russian tank is on another level and easily takes the crown as the most unusual tank of all time. The Big Wind. Great name for an amazing saga in military engineering history. So what's it all about? How does it work? And why does it matter? Let's figure this out together. I'm Ricky, and this is 2-Bit Da Vinci. This video is sponsored by Bespoke Post. It's February 1991. The Western coalition gains the upper hand during the first Persian Gulf War, driving Saddam Hussein's forces back across the sands of Kuwait. The embittered Hussein does not go gently into the good night. No, instead, he goes full on scorched earth, setting fire to over 700 oil wells, turning the desert sands into a literal hellscape. Facing unparalleled economic and ecological disaster, coalition forces scramble to extinguish the towering inferno. With traditional methods failing, the coalition turns to an unlikely resource, Hungary, who swoops in to save the day utilizing an unprecedented feat of innovation. A Frankenstein's monster, Mad Max-style hybrid machine known as Big Wind. At first glance, Big Wind looks like something the evil empire from Star Wars might have used to obliterate Alderaan. But despite its sci-fi look, this machine was very real. While it seems designed to bring utter destruction, actually designed to do the opposite. In fact, it could accurately be described as the world's most badass fire extinguisher. More on that in just a little bit. This particular model was designed by Hungarian oil company MB Drilling in 1991, just in time for the Gulf War's dramatic conclusion. But its origin stretched back a few decades prior and about 50 miles northwest of Hungary in Soviet Russia. But before we get into that, let me tell you about our sponsor this week. Bespoke Post is a monthly membership club delivering awesome boxes of top shelf goods from under the radar brands. Become a member, sign up, take a preference quiz, and you'll get an email with your tailored picks each month. Like this Japanese-inspired box, we love eating sushi together as a family, and that's why this month we decided to get the wabi-sabi. Or a favorite of mine, the siphon, a vacuum siphon coffee maker. We saw one of these when we were in Taiwan recently, and when I saw it on Bespoke Post, I had to have it. The combination of glass, chrome, and beechwood handle is absolutely gorgeous. Or the Retreat, an on-the-go hammock built out of high-quality nylon with polyester ropes and included carabiners. It folds up nice and compact and is sure to be a great addition to your next outdoor adventure. Each box of awesome has around $70 of value, but you only pay a fraction of the price. To get 20% off your first box of awesome, click the link in the description and enter TBDV20 at checkout or go to bespokepost.com/TBDV20. Huge thanks to Bespoke Post and you for supporting the show. During the Cold War, the US and the Soviet Union were less concerned about burning oil fields and more preoccupied with the threat of biological and chemical weapons and, oh yeah, all-out nuclear war. Anticipating these doomsday scenarios, Russia fitted combat vehicles with special seals and filters to protect crews from contamination, but that still left the outside of the vehicles vulnerable. Eagerly searching for ways to swiftly and effectively decontaminate vehicles, Soviet engineers basically acted like little kids mashing up all their action figures together. Ever the pragmatist, the Soviets didn't opt to develop some newfangled contraption. Instead, they scoured their own parts bin and scrapyards, taking bits and pieces from old machines to create something wholly new. And what they came up with was truly remarkable. They began by taking the chassis of a Zil 131 tank, removing the gun turret, and replacing it with a pair of Tamansky R-25 turbojets used on the famous MiG-21 fighter jet. We actually have a whole video on the MiG-21 and the legendary engineering behind it on our sister channel, Project Da Vinci, links in the description. The battle tank chassis meant this monstrous machine could roll into just about any scenario and remain protected, while the turbojets allowed the machine to deploy powerful blasts of air and water. Essentially, the Soviets created a post-apocalyptic, Warhammer-esque pressure washer. I mean, honestly, it was an era of such high stakes and huge scales and ambitions. It was amazing. Let us know in the comments below. For the first few decades, the Soviet monster machine was relegated to clearing off runways, never really having an opportunity to live out its initial purpose, which I guess is a good thing considering that that would have meant all-out chemical and nuclear war. But still, for so long, it seemed like such an incredible idea would ultimately go
to waste.
And this brings us back to where we started. By the late 80s, early 90s, Hungary's Zambi drilling began tinkering with the original Soviet design. Instead of a Zil 131, the Hungarian design utilized a chassis from a T-34 tank, a veteran workhorse that fought invading Germans in World War II. And this new version was designed with a whole new purpose. Instead of decontaminating vehicles, its new mission was to extinguish massive scale fires. The vehicle required a crew of three to operate, in all flame-resistant gear as the tank rolls within 40 feet of a blaze. A driver nestled inside the front cabin navigates toward the flames at 3 miles per hour, protecting the delicate engine and platform on top. At the rear, a second operator controls the engines and water nozzle. And outside the vehicle, a director issues commands to the interior crew via wired controls. And the design was completed in just the nick of time. And if everything wasn't already bad enough, as the Iraqi forces retreated, they set fire to the oil fields. The ultimate jerk move. See, oil fires aren't like forest or structural fires. The pressure from inside the wellhead blasts the oil out at immense speeds, shooting flames as high as 30 feet into the air and at temperatures of 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit, the temperature of molten lava. But the challenges don't stop there. The blazing tower also impacts the surrounding environment. Atmospheric temperatures can reach an unbearable 650 degrees Fahrenheit, while the sand below can reach a scorching 1,300 degrees. This makes approaching the flame nearly impossible while putting the spewing oil at risk of reigniting. Add to this the fact that the flames sit atop a nearly endless fuel supply, and you've got yourself a huge problem. In fact, the general tactic when approaching these fires is to first cut off the fuel source and then attempt to cap the well. The typical firefighting method involves pumping thousands of gallons of water into the well and then utilizing explosives to create a shockwave, pushing the burning fuel and atmospheric oxygen away from the well, essentially like blowing out a candle, but with more Michael Bay style explosions. But these techniques aren't always foolproof, and they can take a long time to work. And as the oil wells burned, time was of the essence. At the midnight hour, Big Wind arrived by aerial transport and rolled a mere 25 feet from the oil wells. Water sourced from the Arabian Gulf fed into the Big Wind via enormous diesel-powered water pumps. The interior crews fired up the jet engines, tuned to operate around 70% capacity so as not to, you know, explode. Opening up the throttles induces an ear-splintering howl of 130 decibels. As loud as a military jet aircraft takeoff from 50 feet away. A trio of high-pressure pipes and nozzles inject water and fire-suppressant chemicals into the jet wash, which catapults out with 27,000 pounds of thrust at 770 miles per hour, delivering up to 220 gallons of water per second. And to put that into perspective, Big Wind could fill an Olympic-sized pool in just under an hour, a feat that typically takes 4 days to accomplish. Big Wind turned out to be the perfect vehicle for the Kuwait oil fires, and for two crucial reasons. First, the intense blast of water and air immediately cuts the flame off from the fuel supply. Footage from the time shows Big Wind snuffing out the pillar in a matter of seconds. But perhaps more crucially, Big Wind also draws huge amounts of heat out of the atmosphere, ensuring that the spewing oil doesn't reignite upon hitting the scorching sand. This also allows teams to approach the well to cap it off once and for all. Following the attack, billions of gallons of crude oil beneath the sands of Kuwait burned. Some estimates say between 4 and 6 million barrels up in flames every single day for 30 weeks. Accumulated losses accounted for as much as 10% of the region's entire oil reserve, worth nearly $160 billion at the current world prices. But more than a global economic disaster, the fires were an even bigger ecological disaster. Daily, 3,400 metric ton clouds of soot spanning over 800 miles blackened the skies over the Gulf states, poisoning rain and killing wildlife as far away as Thailand. These clouds absorb between 75 and 80% of the sun's radiation, causing a drop in climate for the entire region. Airborne studies from the Kuwait oil fires in the spring of 1991 revealed the sulfur dioxide emissions equaled nearly 60% of those from the electrical utilities of the entire United States. The fires also contributed 2% of CO2 emissions that year for the entire planet. During its run, Big Wind put out 9 burning oil wells in Kuwait, more than most of the other teams working at the time. When it comes to net emissions, burning a few hundred gallons of diesel fuel to extinguish flames that were having such a massive impact on the environment is a win in a big time way. Without Big Wind, it's possible those fires could have burned even longer. And who knows how deep the impact might have been. Yes, sometimes the most ecological choice is the one that eliminates fossil fuels, and in the long run, those are the solutions that we want to see flourish. But sometimes in the short term, engineers and problem solvers need to make the best available choice with the best available options. And in this case, Big Wind was the best choice. Today, Big Wind still exists, though it hasn't seen a ton of action lately. Most nations still prefer more traditional methods of extinguishing oil fires. But even now, Big Wind remains one of the most impressive applications of creative problem solving, resulting in one of the wildest, most badass firefighting vehicles the world has ever seen. Do you have other ideas for crazy inventions or engineering marvels you want us to cover in future videos? Sound off in the comments below. But real quick, before we get into that, let me just take a quick minute and say thank you for watching. If you haven't already, hit that like button and the bell icon for notifications for our future videos. Also, join our Discord community and join our newsletter. We can't cover every story we want to, but we want to send out a cool weekly newsletter with some really fun and cool stories. So join that, links in the description.